First things first, I'm the realest.
Realest.
Drop this and let the whole world feel it.
Let them feel it.
And I'm still in the murder business. I can hold you down like I'm giving lessons in physics.
Right, right.
You should want a bad bitch like this.
Huh?
Drop it low and pick it up just like this.
Yeah.
Cup of Ace, cup of Goose, cup of Chris. High heels, something worth a half a ticket on my wrist.
On my wrist.
Taking all the liquor straight, never chase that.
Never.
Stop like we bring an 88 back.
What?
Bring the hooks in where the bass at. Champagne spilling, you should taste that.
What's up, people? Joe Winko here, your favorite Hawaiian guy. And right now, I am on the beach right outside of Los Angeles, California. To be more specific, I'm actually at Will Rogers State Beach in Pacific Palisades, California. This place is so awesome. To be completely honest with all of you guys, as most of you probably know if you've been watching my videos long enough, I never really been into California that much, and I never really thought much of California at first, only because I'm more of an East Coast kind of person and more of a Midwestern kind of person, but I absolutely love it here. This place is just like Los Santos from Grand Theft Auto San Andreas. It's beautiful too. And it's different from the beaches in Florida because there's actually mountains near the beach too. Florida actually does have mountains, as you've seen in my Claremont video, if you guys had watched it. But if you guys haven't, I'll have the link to it in the pinned comments. However, these mountains are much higher than the mountains in Florida. This beach also isn't too crowded either, but you guys have to remember it's really early in the morning, like roughly 7 or 8 a.m. I'm not exactly sure on the time, really. And right behind me is the Pacific Ocean. The Pacific Ocean is actually the largest ocean in the world. If you guys kept going that way, you would eventually end up in Japan or Asia, depending on exactly where you are, but most likely Japan. It is absolutely beautiful here too, and I'm really happy that the beach isn't too crowded either, even though it's Sunday right now. When the strangers brought me here, they told me that the best time to come out here would be during the weekend, because during the week, the traffic around Los Angeles is very busy, but I thought it would be the other way around, but you never know. The state of California is actually the most populated state in the USA. The second most populated state is Texas, and the third most populated state is the state that I live in, Florida. As I said, it's very lovely here. I never actually been to California before this, but I have talked to a lot of people online who live in California, and a lot of people who live in California tell me that they like California more than the state of Florida. I actually can't believe that I'm actually saying this, but to be completely honest with all you guys, I think California is beautiful, and I think it's even prettier than Florida, in my honest opinion. While I was visiting here, I even thought that California might be a nice place to live in. The reason why I thought so is because I use this web forum from time to time called City Data, and I was typing about myself on City Data about how I can't hold a job because of my autism and ADHD, and everyone kept telling me that I should move to California instead of Florida, because the state of California has more services and benefits for mentally disabled people like myself. So that was another reason why I thought living in California wouldn't be bad at all. But then when I asked it to my adoptive parents, they told me that I shouldn't live in California because California is a really broke state that doesn't have any money at all. And I was just like Florida isn't? I mean, seriously. I don't mean to be harsh at all, but Florida looks a lot more poor than this state does. I also heard that stuff in California, like food and everything, is more expensive than normal areas around the USA. I haven't really noticed it that much, to be completely honest with you though. But the thing about it is, California has way too many people. It does appear that California does have some small towns, but the small towns in California, they seem quite a bit out of the way from everything. I thought Bakersfield was really nice. I think that's what it's called, or Bakersville, whatever it was. However, just like in Florida, I would not want to live right by the water in California either, or anywhere near the coastal area of California. Anywhere that's west of the San Andreas Fault. And I'm about to tell you guys why. First of all, it's way too expensive to live in coastal California. So if I lived in California, I'd have to live inland, and I'm all right with that because there's a major reason why, and that's not it. The major reason why I wouldn't want to live in coastal California is because they experience earthquakes a lot. And around here, I've been even noticing signs that this is a tsunami risk area. And that was absolutely terrifying to think about, really, because the Pacific Ocean is gigantic. And it's a bit creepy, too. I noticed that the waves are more active here than the waves on the Atlantic side of the USA. Another thing that I noticed about California that reminded me of the state of Florida is that along the beach, they have evacuation route signs. However, these evacuation route signs are not for hurricanes. These evacuation route signs are for tsunamis. They literally have them like all around the beaches in California, which is good in my opinion. I thought that it was stupid for them to have evacuation route signs for hurricanes in Florida, but it makes much more sense to have them for tsunamis in California. Because the thing is, they can always predict when a hurricane is going to come. They see it spinning out in the ocean, and they always usually have a good idea of exactly where it's going to make landfall. And people usually have tons of time to get out of harm's way. But with tsunamis, they don't have that much time to get out of harm's way. I mean, you still have a general idea of which direction to go away from the water and to head east. But another thing is, tsunamis can actually travel pretty far inland. I heard that the tsunami that hit Japan traveled like six... I heard that the tsunami that hit Japan traveled 6 miles inland. But they can also travel much farther inland than that. So even if you do head east, you're not always heading to a safer area. With tsunamis, the safest thing to do is try to get as high above ground as possible, like on top of a really large hill or on top of a really large mountain, a place with high elevation so the water cannot get to you. And you have to do it really soon because you cannot outrun a tsunami. Those waves travel really, really fast. Just a heads up for all of you. But to be completely honest with all of you, I've actually never heard of a tsunami hitting the state of California. I'm pretty sure it might have happened sometime, but as far as I know, I never really heard of that happening. In recent history, at least. But that doesn't mean it could never happen, so that's another scary thing about California. And another creepy thing about California, too, is that they get wildfires from time to time. Those don't really happen in urban areas, those happen more in the rural areas of California. It's because California is so dry, much drier than the state of Florida. I never heard of wildfires happening in the state of Florida because it's too damp and too moist and too humid. But don't get me wrong though, fires still do happen in the state of Florida, but mainly it's because someone was too stupid and accidentally left something in the microwave too long or some shit like that, as you guys should know. But it's so damp in Florida and so muggy and humid that wildfires in the state of Florida, those don't really happen at all. I honestly never heard of that happening in the state of Florida. But in California, it happens very often. It seems like almost every year they get impacted by a wildfire, and it's horrible. However, the thing is, the doomsday experts are expecting that something really bad will happen in California, that the San Andreas Fault will eventually rupture from a really, really large earthquake. I'm not too familiar with earthquakes, to be honest with you guys. I've been more intrigued by hurricanes because I actually live in the state of Florida, but they're predicting that one day a really powerful earthquake, like a level 8 or a level 9 or a level 10 on the Richter scale, will cause the San Andreas Fault to rupture, and that it'll break off the entire coastal half of California, and that it'll fall into the Pacific Ocean, and that billions of people are going to die. And the most fucked up thing about it, and the most messed up thing about it is, they have no way of predicting when that's actually going to happen. It could happen at any time, even right now. But I hope it doesn't, because that would suck, because I'm actually here right now. But either way, I hope it never happens at all, but that's really scary to think about. So that's the reason why I don't want to live in California. Places along Eastern California would probably be okay, but not places like this. It's still an awesome place to visit though. It reminds me so much of Los Santos from Grand Theft Auto San Andreas. It's interesting because I live in Florida, which reminds me of Grand Theft Auto Vice City, but right now I'm in California, which reminds me of Grand Theft Auto San Andreas. All I need to do now is visit New York so I have Grand Theft Auto 3. But this is a really nice beach. It's massive too. It almost seems like it's bigger than the beach I went to in Florida where I did my live streams at a long time ago. Another interesting fact about California is that California cannot be hit with hurricanes at all. The reason why California never gets hurricanes is because the waters on the coast of California are way too cold. California has a cold water current running down it, which makes the waters really cold, and hurricanes need warm water to get their energy. So storm surge wouldn't be much of a risk, but if a really bad earthquake happens somewhere, it might be able to generate a tsunami, and that definitely would not be good. However, I believe that California does have tsunami warning systems, but you don't know about it. But you don't really have much lead time with it as you do for hurricanes, because when they see a hurricane, they can see it out in the ocean days before it makes landfall. I believe a tsunami warning, you only have like a few minutes, really. And it's scary too. I do remember reading online that they said it might actually be possible for a hurricane to impact California one day. But in order for that to happen, an extreme El Nino would need to be in place. And the waters along coastal California would have to get extremely warm so the hurricane still has enough energy to make landfall here. I actually wrote a story about that happening, Hurricane Winko, a hurricane that hits California. I honestly wouldn't want it named after myself though. Even though I'm not too thrilled with the West so much, well, I'm definitely thrilled with it now, I think it's beautiful, but back then, even though I wasn't so thrilled with the West at first, I still would not want a hurricane to hit California. Even back then, I didn't. It was just an interesting ideal I had. You can blame my autism mind for that. You guys know how I'm into disaster tourism and tragedy and stuff like that. Doesn't mean I enjoy it, though. But it is what it is. But I honestly believe, even if hurricanes were able to hit California, I don't think they would be that much of an issue because California has a much higher elevation than the state of Florida. And also, the most dangerous thing about hurricanes is the storm surge. And literally right here, there's mountains right in front of the beach. So all these people who live in their houses on top of the mountains and everything, they would honestly be safe from storm surge, unless the storm surge was like catastrophic or something like that. But usually hurricanes aren't powerful enough to produce a storm surge that's that powerful. I do remember reading online that in one instance during a hurricane, the storm surge was 30 feet high. I can't confirm whether that's true or not because I read it so long ago. However, these mountains seem much taller than 30 feet, in my opinion at least. So even if a really bad storm surge from a hurricane was ever able to make it to California, I think everyone living on these hills would be in the clear, from that at least. Another major thing I've been seeing out here was that there's a lot of houses on mountains here and a lot of houses on hills. That's what I've been noticing. They're really fancy houses too, ones that I could never afford to live in at all, at least not now. But they're still cool to look at. I honestly would never want to live on a mountain or a hill. The reason why is because in California, they get the earthquakes so often, and I imagine that could be really dangerous if you're really high up on a mountain living in a house and the earthquake starts and then your house falls off the mountain or something like that. And also because over time, mountains eventually wear down and it could crumble and your house could still fall off the mountain even though there's no earthquakes. I knew that California had really high mountains, and I remember that Arkansas had mountains too. Those were the Ozark Mountains. But the Ozark Mountains are a lot shorter than the mountains out in California. I was talking about that in a chat room a long time ago, and someone actually told me that that was because the Ozark Mountains are a much older mountain system than the mountains out in California. And I was like, really? I thought that the older mountains would be taller than the newer mountains. But eventually, over time, it's that mountains wear down over time. And that was really interesting learning that. In addition to that, there's actually one song that always made me think of California. There's actually a lot of songs that remind me of California, but the one that comes to my autism mind right now is I'm So Fancy by Iggy Azalea. I love that song. It was playing in my head while we were driving here. That's another funny thing about the song too. When the girl thought that there was an interstate that went to Los Angeles to Tokyo. However, that might actually be possible, really. They probably could build an interstate that goes from Los Angeles to Tokyo. It would be really long though, and it might be a bit difficult to construct. But roads do go over water, like the Golden Gate Bridge. That one goes over water, but I'm not exactly sure how the Golden Gate Bridge is set up, really. I mean, I don't think it's just floating there. I think that the pillars have to go all the way down to the ground level of the water. And the ocean is a lot deeper than the San Francisco Bay, so they would need tons of concrete to build that. Also, the tides might affect that too, so it probably wouldn't be possible, but it'd be cool if it was. However, if they made a road going from Los Angeles to Tokyo, then it would only be fair if they also made a road going from New York to England. But we're getting off topic. I always do that. You can blame my autism for that. And another thing that I heard over and over again, which is the reason why I didn't really want to visit California at first, was because I've heard that it's not really safe for anyone to wear a red bandana in the state of California. However, that honestly depends on exactly where in California you go, really. It's not like I wanted to visit any hood places in California, and this definitely does not look like a hood place at all. It seems more like a laid-back family place with a bunch of random people chilling and enjoying their time on the beach. So I'm really happy about that. However, I'm not going to be visiting the Cecil Hotel because that's in a really creepy part of Los Angeles, and I want to stay away from the creepy parts of Los Angeles. So I'm not going to be going there. So that's the reason why I won't have a video of me visiting the Cecil Hotel. Just so you all know. I also have more videos of me in California. Just check the pinned comments for them. I'll be putting all of them there as I upload them. Or my adventure videos playlist I have on YouTube. I'll have the link to that in the pinned comments as well, because that's where they'll all be. So that's basically it for my video of me on the beach in Los Angeles. I hope you guys all liked it. Have you ever been to this beach before? And what do you think of it? Let me know in the comments. And what do you think of this video? And what do you think of California? What is your favorite beach in California? Have you ever lived in California? And what do you think of this video? Let me know in the comments and let's get a conversation started. So don't forget to like, don't forget to comment, don't forget to subscribe, and don't forget to like me on Facebook and follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and Tumblr. So that's it. Peace out, people.